All right, guys, well, I'm back today with a really cool product from SafeVest, and this is their Level 3A Bulletproof Backpack. If you follow the channel, you'll know I recently did a review on one of SafeVest's concealable 3A bulletproof vests, and it worked out really well. I was incredibly surprised at how well it stopped multiple hits. In fact, all of these bullets were captured inside the SafeVest, and it still retained about 80% of its Kevlar layers without any holes through them. So I believe it would have continued to take hit after hit, and I was just so impressed, and I'm gonna leave that demonstration at the end of this video so you guys can see how well it stopped everything and to show you exactly what I'm talking about, the potential it does have to stop multiple hits and still remain in a good form. It doesn't crunch up and ball up on itself. It's really stable and secure, and it is a pretty awesome option. Now, one downfall, and it is the same with this backpack, is this is made overseas, and there is no actual certification stitched onto the plates themselves. Now, if you reach out to SafeVest, they do have a certification, and that certification is available on their website of a vest they got certified. But again, if for resale value or to give it away or to even get it and look at the plates themselves that are inside this backpack or their vest, you won't see a certification sewn into those. Something to consider, and if you need a certification, go over to their website and either print that out or you can ask them to send you a copy. With that being said, let's take a look at the backpack itself and how well it actually feels and how well it's usable, you know, because when you're talking about a bulletproof backpack, it goes beyond something that you may wear occasionally to something that you are going to be wearing every day at school or your job, taking to college, something like that. You want to make sure it's got all the features you want for everyday practicality. But again, stay tuned to the end to see the bulletproof rating when we really blast that other piece of Kevlar inside the vest. So right off the bat, I want to talk about price, and the price of this vest is $190, and they do have those free shipping options. But if you use the coupon code 704TACTICAL, you'll save 10%, dropping the price down about $20 to $170, and they also accept PayPal. Now, what you get, again, is the backpack itself, which is actually a very nice, well-constructed backpack, in my opinion, plus that Level 3A armor insert that's located in the side. So I'm going to show you guys right here where that armor insert is, and it's located right here in the side. Now, this is a little bit thicker than all of my other 3A armor, and you guys can see in the outro video of us actually shooting that other Kevlar insert that they actually have some foam and plastic in here that keeps its rigidity. And I really like that because the backpack stays solid. So if you do fill it with a lot of heavy things, it's not gonna flop over on itself, and this keeps the armor distributed across the entire length of the backpack, providing you adequate protection. So you can see where the insert is. And also, guys, this is not just something that you can wear as a backpack and run away in a defensive situation, but if you had to flip it around, as you can see in the intro of this video, you can actually wear this as a front plate if you were engaging a target. That is pretty convenient, and it's nice if you have this in your car or in your trunk and you need to deploy it, you can actually use this as a front plate, and it works out pretty well. The main compartment of this backpack has some pretty nice zippers. It opens up pretty good. And you guys can see in here, it's got a USB and a headphone jack that connects to the side right here. So what you can actually do is plug your USB in. If you want to hook up a USB charger, you can do that in here like a battery bank. And you can hook up your headphones to keep them inside the backpack. And that's going to help everything become more water resistant if you wanted to keep that stuff in there and just hook up to the side of your backpack. You also have a spot to put a laptop and other books and things like that, and another keeper right here. And then when you open up the front compartment, what you'll see is a wide variety of different little areas to put things, your pencils, things like that. It's just really organized. It's got a lot of nice features of a quality backpack. And again, it's a weighty backpack. It's not the lightest in the world, but I like that because when you're talking about a backpack like this, a lot of people may use it just for your everyday backpack needs, books and work-related stuff, laptops, but some people might use this as a go bag or a tactical defense bag. What they may do, like you saw in the intro, is stash AR-9 and AR-45, in the case of the intro of this video, a Glock, a handgun, a few other magazines, maybe a trauma kit, a medical kit, and you want a strong, sturdy backpack if you're storing all those items, and I think that's perfect for that. Also, if you do use this for like a tactical style defensive bag, it's nice because it's not embroidered with a ton of tactical looking stuff. There's no Molly attachments or hook and loop or Velcro. It's just a nice discreet backpack that, man, has a nice volume in here. So when you're looking at that AR-45 at the intro of this video, that's actually a 4.5-inch barrel, and it's got an adjustable SBA-4 brace, and that entire thing fits in here assembled. So if you had an AR-9 with about a 4 or 4.5-inch barrel and a smaller brace setup, it would fit in here perfectly. It was really easy to deploy, and I absolutely love the size of this pack. It's large enough to hold an AR pistol with a short enough barrel, or you can actually disassemble maybe a 10.5-inch AR-9 and put it in here, something like that. It also has these side pockets if you wanted to store maybe a small water bottle, a cell phone, a calculator, things like that. And overall, guys, the straps and back of this are very comfortable. You can see it's got these elevated, kind of spongy feeling little kind of grooves right here, and this allows you to kind of vent the air through your back. So if you're wearing this all day, it helps cool you off. The straps themselves are really nice. They're padded really nice, and they have that same material right there. And they also have that front clip if you were going to hike a long ways or you really had a lot of weight in here. This will strap it to your chest accordingly. And everything about this backpack seems like a really quality backpack, and it's so discreet you don't even know there's armor inside. So right now, that pretty much concludes the review of the pack itself. I'm going to switch over, and what you'll be seeing is actually me shooting the bulletproof vest, but it's the exact same Kevlar plate that's in the vest, minus those little lips on the side for the vest, that it is in this backpack. So this rating is exactly the same, and it should stop the exact same amount of bullets. So that is such a cool thing. Let's go take a look at that, and then we'll conclude our video. First up, 5 shots of 9mm at about 10 yards. We'll see how this does. A good baseline. It better stop all of these, and I think it will. So here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now this one is on the borderline of the armor. The armor does sag down low in the carrier, something to consider. So we may have actually had that one go through, but let's check. So nothing has went through. Even that top shot actually still stopped the armor. So right off the bat, I am really impressed, and the armor itself seems to be holding up with its integrity. So let's strap it back on and shoot it some more. Next up is 357 Magnum. What I want to do is kind of give a realistic test of what this can stop, but I really want to focus on a few calibers. One being 9mm and its multi-strike capability, and the next being a more powerful cartridge, 357 Magnum out of this Colt Lawman. So I have 6 loaded up, and we're going to see, even if after the damage it took with those 5 9mm, can it stop 6 357 Magnum? At that point, I'll be incredibly impressed for a high value setup for $250. But let's see. All right, guys, so we've got all of our hits pretty much square. It looks like, though, that this one right here actually missed the armor. It looks like it just went and grazed the side of it. So what we will do is open this up and take a look and see what we have. I fully expect the one that missed to go right through, but... So yeah, guys, this one just missed the armor, but it stopped all of the other 357. So this plate is doing an amazing job. I'm actually really surprised. So we are, I guess, 5 hits with 357, 5 hits with 9mm, all stops. Let's keep shooting it. 6 rounds of 45 ACP out of this High Point carbine in the HTA stock. Looks like we've got hits right on top of hits in multiple locations. Let's see if it stops. And yes, guys, we only have that 357 still that missed the armor completely, but it stopped everything else. You can see it's bulging out a little bit, but guys, for $250 budget armor, this stuff is doing pretty darn good. Let's keep shooting it. 10 rounds of 9mm. All center of mass hits. Let's see, though, did it stop them? Yes, guys, it just keeps stopping them. I mean, this is multi-hit function out of budget body armor with that code, and that code again, guys, is
704 Tactical for 10% off. What I want to do now is we'll probably shoot it just a couple of more times and then we'll test the stab rating. Now we're at about 7 yards. I've got 38 Special Plus P and 357 Mix Bag in this cylinder. Let's see how it does. All right, guys, one hit really low and one hit high, but let's see. Nothing. It 100% stopped it. This was the only one that went through, and again, that was the one that missed the armor. Let's try to stab this thing and tear into it. All right, guys, so I've got this ultra cheap knife. I left all my knives. I cleaned them out of the truck the other day, but I've got this one and I'm going to put a lot of force on it. That's the good thing about this larger knife is it's got a sharp enough point. We're just testing to see if we can stab through. So here we go. All right. Now those are pretty tough stabs. And guys, nothing went through. It stopped all of that. So, I mean, that's pretty darn good in my opinion. I think that definitely passes that stab test. Let's open this up and take a look. All right, guys. So I've counted about 29 or 30 hits. And this is the only one, the 357 Magnum, that kind of barely nicked the side. That is the only one that went through and that missed the armor. So, I mean, guys, even multi-strike hits back to back on top of each other, over and over again, up to 357 Magnum, this stopped it, no problem whatsoever. This, guys, is incredibly impressive for the price. Remember what I said in the intro, you know, the plates themselves are not technically, each of them have the certification stamped on them, but the company I did confirm will email you the certifications if you want to see those. And look at all these bullets, guys, that this thing has stopped. So for me, the proof is here. Again, I'm just doing the independent evaluation of this product. And man, it seems like it works really, really good, especially for that price. So those are all the bullets. Looks like this is the Kevlar, and this actually does have foam and plastic, which may add the rigidity that we're seeing here to this. And this is a lot of Kevlar inside here. More than I've seen in other plates, and maybe that's how they're keeping this rigidity with the plastic and just the overall performance. So what I'm going to do is collect all the bullets and then show you guys all of those. Guys, we pulled off about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 layers of Kevlar, and all of these rounds right here were trapped inside the Kevlar. You can see the deformation of some, and some still remain almost intact, but all of this was stopped by this armor. And I want to iterate, guys, look how much Kevlar is left. I'd say about 85% or 80% of the Kevlar is still here, meaning this could continue to take hit after hit after hit after hit. In fact, you could probably reseal this, remove that Kevlar, flatten it back out, and be good to go for another, I don't know, 40 or 50 rounds. This is kind of shocking me, especially coming with an overseas product that has no actual certifications on the armor. This is incredibly impressive, and I really do just love the fact that this is a solid set of armor for a very reasonable price. So you guys can see how well it stopped everything. So I hope you guys like this video, and I hope it gives you a high value option for a bulletproof backpack. And remember, again, if you want this pack, the link will be in the description below, as well as the coupon code 704 Tactical for 10% off. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a good one.